Well, folks, I wasn't hoping to make a video like this, but I guess I'm gonna have to, because this is one of those cases of first or score turning strikeout. Although, it's not total loss. We're gonna start with this thing right here. I knew I shouldn't have picked it up. I really, really, really knew I shouldn't have picked it up, especially considering the price tag that it's got on it. But I've got a perverse sense of interest. So I did anyways, because I figured, you know, maybe it would be interesting at least for a video. And I'm here to tell you right now, it's not even interesting for a video. Not even for its own video, not even for a video with others. It's just purely uninteresting crap. That doesn't even work quite right. If we turn off this light here and take a look at the display, you can kind of get an idea here of what it looks like. It's not perfectly bright anymore, but it's not bad. It really isn't all that bad. And it's got a redeeming feature in that it's actually got a buzzer on it. A lot of these pulsar clock radios don't even have buzzers on them. There's your tuning dial there. And the styling is kind of neat. There's your buttons on top. That price tag sticks out like a sore thumb. I did actually pay that. And I kept the zip tie on the cord because I'm here to tell you right now, I'm not keeping it. I think it's trash. And in fact, let me show you something here. We're gonna go ahead and demo the alarm, or I'll try and demo the alarm here. Oh, of course, you know what figures? It's working fine on video. Oh, there we go. Yeah, there we go. Now it's acting up. You see, if I fiddle with this switch a little bit, even just a little wee bit, it turns off and stops working right. Like, look at that. Hope you saw that. It's on, auto right now. But I can't get it to stay on. So, the one redeeming feature it could have potentially had is broken. I can set things really nicely. Like, these buttons are in perfect condition. They're just fine, not dirty or anything. Well, that's the wrong one. Maybe it would help if I hit the right one. Perfect. There's nothing wrong with those. I'd imagine the snooze button works fine too. All the buttons are fine except for this one right here, which is the one that I need to actually work. Doesn't that figure, right? So let's have a listen to the thoroughly unexciting alarm. I can tell you, I'm already going to spoil it right now. It's thoroughly unexciting. It sucks. So, let's have a listen. You know what? Sure, why not, eh? Like I said, thoroughly unexciting, and it's even got a little bit of hum in it, suggesting that maybe the capacitors are going bad. Snooze button works, see? Told you so. How about the sleep timer? Does that work? Yeah, the sleep timer seems to work. But again, there's a little bit of buzz in the audio, which suggests to me that maybe the caps aren't all that great. Okay, forget about the alarm. Let's have a band scan. Turn up the sound a little bit, because as you'll see, this thing actually is quite pants. Oh, come on, you piece of junk. There's a station here that it can't even pick up. I know what station it is. And I can't even make it that loud, and it already starts crackling. What a piece. Listen to that. We're at low volume, and the speakers are already cracking. Piece of junk. Okay, let's try AM. Well, that's not even gonna work. I can guarantee you, this isn't even gonna do anything. Holy crap. It works? Wow.
You know, whether it's Boston can be very...
I'm impressed. Nope, stop picking that like it's supposed to. Well, there you go. Thoroughly unexciting piece of crap that is going to go back the instant I get the chance to take it back, because I don't like it, I don't want it. If you are, for whatever reason, wondering what this is, it's a Pulsar model ECR13. There's some more information about it. Reportedly takes a 9-volt C-cell. Yeah, I think somebody made a mistake there, although maybe they were called C-cells back then. Imported by Canadian Tire, so you know that it's not really all that great. There's some crap here. There's a sticker. I don't know what that is. Patent? Oh, quality control passed. Interesting place to put one of those. We can see the speaker, the world's smallest and crappiest speaker in there. And a vent. There's where a dimmer switch would go if it actually had one. So I realize I'm probably being a little bit harsh by calling this a complete piece of crap, but let's face it, it is actually a complete piece of crap. It is even worse than I thought it was when I picked it up, because I figured, you know what, it would have a couple of redeeming features. Like maybe the buzzer is interesting, maybe the alarm will actually work, but both of those turned out to not be true. And I can guarantee you, if I keep it around here, the capacitors are going to fail because it's buzzing in the audio. I don't know if that's a transformer problem. The power around here is certainly not that bad, so I don't know. But I can tell you one thing, that's not sticking around here for very long. This right here is the real sad story. It's a GE 74634. I believe it's a 4634B. In really, for one of these, it's in really excellent condition, as you can see. It's not all dirty or anything. And the controls all seem to work, or did seem to work at least anyways. There you can get a glance at the controls, the snooze button and all of that. Tuning control on the side. I don't believe it's got a dimmer, but maybe it does. No, I don't believe it does. There's some more information about it. Yep, 4634B, 4 watts, made in China. Here's your date code. Oops, I should probably show the date code. Might be an idea. Again, probably a bit too much. They had 3 of them, believe it or not. 3 identical units. This was the cleanest of the 3, which is why I picked it up. But there's a bit of a problem. See that? Now, ordinarily, somebody's probably would probably go into the comments and say, "Hey, dummy, you didn't plug it in." Well, I'm here to report to you that, you follow the cord here, it is plugged in. And it's not even doing anything. It is completely lifeless. It worked in the store, which is why I grabbed that one and not one of the other ones. And it worked when I tested it on my workbench at work. But now, of course, when I want to go actually use it at home, nope, nothing. So, I was going to do a nice band scan and see how the radio sounded on this thing, but I guess that's not really even going to happen because it doesn't work. So, that's going back as well. I was really hoping I would end up keeping this one, even though I probably paid a bit too much. But alas, I guess it wasn't meant to be. I was actually going to use it where that Zonex up there is, because even though I like the Zonex, I would like to keep that thing out of regular use because I want the motor to last. But I guess that Zonex is going to stay up there for a bit. Oh well, like I said, I guess it just wasn't meant to be. Here's where we get to the redeeming features of the score here. I don't know if this works. I really don't. And considering the fact that it is same price and not even exchangeable, well, you know what, if it doesn't work, I'm probably going to go hog heaven on it. Beat it with a baseball bat, throw it in the pool, all kinds of things. Might even microwave it for all your viewing pleasure. But either way, it's here. cheap little piece of crap 5-port video switcher. I'm not sure why they felt the need to label these with their, you know, dedicated things like VCR, Xbox, PlayStation. I don't have any of those. I wonder if these are removable, actually. They might be removable. In which case, if they are removable, I'm just going to take them out of there, because there's... that's not what's going to be going there, so... if they are removable, then it works, anyways. If it doesn't work, then forget it. I'm not going to waste my time. I'm just going to go hog heaven on it. But now you can see it. It's just a standard video switcher. Composite and S-Video. It's a little bit of dirt on the switches there. But I figure that it can't be any worse than the Nextech that I've got already over there, and the Nextech is actually pretty decent. So that might make a nice addition. Don't know when I'll get around to using it, because I need to do some other studio work first. I didn't need these. I think it was Wilkes85 that actually said, yeah, Wilkes85 again, that said these Memorex tapes were junk. And based on my limited experience with Memorex tapes of, you know, VHS tapes and other various tapes, yeah, they are kind of junk. But you know what? What the hell? These were $1.99 for three of them. And even if I probably will only end up using them for voice. I might use them in that cassette dictation machine that I actually do still have. I bet you all didn't think I still had that. But I still have it. I might end up using those in that. See if I can get that dictation machine to work. You know, that I think would be pretty cool. I'm going to use that in video. But either way. This came in a care package. I didn't actually buy these specifically. It's a bunch of DSL filters. That's all that's left. It's DSL filters and an instruction sheet. I was hoping the splitter would be in there, but it's not. But I'm not going to lose any sleep over that. No, these were the star of the show with that package. Some recycled floppy diskettes. One box is sealed, one box is not. All the diskettes are there, and they even come with labels. So I figure, you know what the hell? I can always use more diskettes to expand the collection. I don't know if they're any good, but the only way to know is to find out. I only paid $2 for that package, so who cares, really? And then lastly, we've got Aerosmith's Greatest Hits on cassette tape. This is probably junk, but I'm going to have to listen to it first before I call it junk. And the fourth, Big Shiny Tunes. All right. So there's your scores. I hope you enjoyed the video. Sorry that the first little bit of it was kind of depressing, but that's just the way it goes. Sometimes you strike out. Check it out, folks. Not such a strikeout after all, is it? What happened was, as I was fiddling around with it last night, very early, actually it was more like very early yesterday morning, and I took my fist, actually it wasn't this fist, it was the one that I was holding the camera with, took my fist and I shoved it in the front panel, and all of a sudden it lit up like a Christmas tree, started working perfectly. So I don't know if there's probably something loose in this area here, but hey, I'm happy that it works now. And these buttons are in perfect condition. Work nicely. No problems at all. Now, that doesn't necessarily absolve it of being returned. I could very well, and I'm probably going to take it with me on Monday when I go to go back to work. I'm probably going to go back to the store because, if I remember correctly, I have the morning of Monday off, so... I'm going to go ahead and do that. Let me turn the radio off. So, like I said, it doesn't necessarily absolve it. There were two other units there, so I'll see if they're still there, one, and two, if they're actually worth my time, even more than this one is. Because this one has got a scratchy band switch here, and also a scratchy tuning dial, I think. So we're going to have a listen to the radio. I'm not going to do a band scan, because, or a full band scan. I'm not going to go into AM, because... there's not really much on AM anyways, and this isn't a spectacular tuner, so probably won't be doing much DXing anyways. Here it's silent. I'm going to turn that down because I'll probably get my ears blasted if I do this. Yep, you can see it's silent. Completely silent. Here we go. Thank you. You know, it's working a little better than it was last night.
J'ai une éducation assez semblable.
Tuner also sticks a bit. Which is, I think it's that that's the same problem. There's another GE in here. There. And it's the same problem that GE up there has.
Since you had to walk at it.
By elbow.
Listen to that. All that scratching is definitely not on the radio. So. Well, there's your FM band scan. Let's go ahead and set the alarm here and have a listen to that. As you can hear, nothing special, really. But I do like the design of it, which is why I picked it up. even if it wasn't all that special, I still probably would have picked it up just simply for the design. Because, I mean, who doesn't want a clock radio that's got wood grain sides, nice brown, or wood grain top, nice brown sides, and a silver accent? I think it just looks classy. It's much better than the modern things, which are made entirely of white or silver. There's another modern clock in there. I got a couple of them. I got a black one, I think, over there. Made entirely out of black plastic. Yeah, black plastic crap, if you ask me. But anyways. Yeah, you just heard me call a Sony Dream Machine garbage. That thing wouldn't even wake up a flea. Thank you for watching. If you have any comments, feel free to leave them down below. And this is CP666 signing off. I hope to see you next time. Till then, very glad that we could have a little bit of a better ending to the video than what we had. A little bit of a better video, anyways. Happier video. We go for happy on this channel, anyways.